Okay, y'all, we're out here at Oak Grove Road in Winslow, or actually outside of Winslow. Here's part of the yard. They've got some raised garden beds here, which are kind of nice. Had some tomatoes, didn't even harvest them, which is a sadness. But the road kind of Y's right here. So you got road marking two sides of your property, which is at least a clear property marker. And then here's the house. Small house built in 1959. Neat little kind of pull around driveway. We'll get more to that later. Let's head in. Kind of a cool little entryway through the bushes here. Kind of make a neat walking path onto some natural stone, which is cool. As you walk in, you've got your entryway slash living space. You know, it was built in the 50s, so it is wood paneled walls on every wall, and they are kind of flimsy. But it's all in pretty good shape, really. I mean, they built houses to last back in those days. I see nothing on the ceilings to indicate water. Well, what's that? I think that's more dust than anything. Could be. If it is, it's really old, and the roof is fairly new. So here is a gas fireplace, and that'll provide heat for this place, because it does need some heat sources. As we go into kind of a dining area here, I'll step back, and then into the kitchen here to the left. So gas range, basic but relatively new. I mean, maybe 10 years old or something. And then, I mean, relative to the house. And then here's your countertops, which they are just really old. I mean, antique at this point. The coloring and coatings kind of even worn off them. And then you got a little window to your porch and a window to outside. All of the windows are metal. Aluminum or steel, and they're probably original equipment with the house in 1959. Doesn't look like they've been changed out. Refrigerator is pretty standard, but it does work. Then we go out to an unfinished porch. It is covered, but unfinished. And that could be a problem for VA financing. Not 100% sure, because it doesn't get into your actual heated and cooled space, but it could be an issue. And the porch leads back to a little deck on the side, which again, the wood is getting very old, but and it's starting to rot a little, but it's not there yet. Could definitely use some love. And here's that kind of wraparound drive area that leads up to your barn slash garage over there. And the yard is fenced, I would say, with a 4-foot fence. Your Great Dane is going to have to choose to stay in it, but it is fenced. And let's go take a look at the rest of the house. Little built-in storage thing here in the porch. Taking a second to lock the doors. There we go. And we're to the bathroom, which is actually, for a house this size, is massive. They clearly just redid the bathroom. It's got a newer toilet. The floor is linoleum, so it's old, but it's actually in really good shape for its age. The size of the bathroom is really good. Big shower head. New, looks like plumbing fixtures there. And then down into the bathtub. And then it is well tiled. You know, the tile looks nice, newer, newish grout. And a nice border that matches the cabinet of the sink. Cabinetry there. Cabinetry all up around the vanity as well, which is kind of nice. There's your agent. Howdy. And then a nice big size linen closet there. Bedroom number one is tiny. There's about enough room in here for maybe a queen size bed with no space on the edges at all. Like not even room for an alarm clock. Decent sized little closet. And then some room in the space above the closet. On to bedroom number two. And this is the room that actually shares the wall with the room we just looked at. I know you were talking about maybe knocking this wall down, seeing if it's load bearing. I will ask that question. And there's, you got a couple nice windows and views here. And another closet about the same size. Maybe a little bigger. This whole room is quite a bit bigger than the other one. Same storage up on top. And now we go to last but not least room. About the same size as the last one, which is pretty decent size. Two windows, one to the porch, one again to outside, which is nice. They've got a hookup for a washer dryer connection here, although there is one in the basement as well, and we'll go to the basement here in just a second. Closet. And a little bit of storage space above the closet as well. Now we'll go to the basement, which is really, really steep getting down. So, not a lot of lights there either. Okay. Pardon me while I negotiate this. It's basically a ladder. So the floor, the walls, everything's concrete down here. It is not finished. There is a little bit of a musty smell, but it's a basement. Nothing that I would find alarming. Here are the two window air units. Nothing to indicate that they're not functioning other than the fact that they're not in windows. PEX plumbing lines to the washer, which is good. Washer, dryer, little prep area there. Your water heater in the back. The water heater looks old and is aging. No doubt about it. That's going to be a concern. Go into this other room. It's been used kind of more as a utility or workshop, which is kind of cool. I think you might like that actually, Brian. And there is a door to get out to kind of your backyard there. And then come in here, a little bit more storage. They've got some leftover tile there from the bathroom, which is good, helpful. And that's pretty much it on the inside. Let's go outside. So here we are at the back of the home. It's got that neat little drive-through. So you can drive all the way from one driveway to the next and hit your barn as well. Here is the back view of the home, along with the basement door I just came out of. And some nice natural stone steps leading up to the front. And as you come around to the back, used to be a spot for a swing. You could hang a deer there too. Not saying, just saying. And here's kind of the rest of your acres. The property does have a fence that leads you to believe the end of the property is right there at that tree line. And here is your fenced in backyard area. Like I said, it's fenced in for a dog, but a Great Dane is a big dog. And of course, he'd have to choose to stay in there, but there's plenty to do in there. And there's a dog door. Not sure if it's big enough for a Great Dane or not, but it's on the back. Your dog might really like it. And here's the barn. You might really like this. There is power to it, although it's not on right now. Looks like most of the power's been capped off. So I can't show you any light. But my phone's pretty good. Several birds in here that kind of scare the bejesus out of you. Makes for an entertaining showing visit. Like some shelves over here. Everything looks to be pretty old. Okay. Well, that's going to wrap it up, y'all. It'll take a while to get this uploaded, and I'll give you a call. Talk to you later.